We all know that fresh air is important. In public rooms, a complete air change every 3 hours is prescribed. But in winter, opening windows all the time means losing heat, and of course you forget them. What if I told there's a way to get fresh air without wasting energy and suffering cold air streams? And even better, it can contribute to the central heating with excellent efficiency. It can also become the main heating if you are off-grid. And finally, you can enjoy these advantages also in summer, because the system is reversible. Today, I will tell you in video 85 why to build an active, not passive, air heat exchange system. Then, if you like the idea, I will make a video showing its construction. But I am convinced that it makes sense, and the construction will anyway start this week. Unfortunately, the project with the supercapacitors for starting a car has to wait, because the purchased parts were not good. It was a print board with 6 of them on top of it. Now, instead of spending 300 euros on first class quality, which is not really necessary for this application, I'm trying to make the best of existing material, including voltage balancing and also diagnostic LEDs. I think that will be appreciated by the budget conscious audience. I already told this in a short video on Wednesday, and I thank you for your patience. But also today's project is relevant for the winter. A heat pump for active heat recovery to fresh air. I dismounted a dehumidifier. This is an old one, and will recover heat from outgoing air and pre-warm incoming air. This means better air quality in your house without cold drafts. You can ask, why not use a simple exhaust fan? And then the central heating will take care of the cold air. Of course you can. The most important is indeed that the bed indoor air quality is improved. And also a simple fan does the job. But it is a pity to throw so much heat on the street. That can be 300 watts of loss with 40 cubic meters per hour and 0 degrees Celsius outside. With a very modest input power of 140 watts plus 3 watts for the two fans together, you have 500 watts of heat power or more in your incoming airflow, and that is pure health if you are not in a polluted place, and also very comfortable. It's much better than the passive air heat recovery systems, because the input air is much warmer and the output air is even colder than outside. And who cares? This is a small-scale version of industrial heat recovery. With just 140 watts of power, of electrical power, the system can recover about 500 watts of heat, thanks to the heat pump's high energy efficiency. And because the outgoing air is already warm, the system can achieve even a better COP, or the coefficient of performance. Then when the cold side is kept at a low temperature, like in a fridge, so maybe we get even 600 watts. Now you have a significant heat capacity for a single room, also pretty large, which will save on the central heating. Typically you would install this in the rooms where you are during many hours, for example the living or the sleeping room. The central heating may even be switched off for a couple of hours, or when the outside temperatures are mild. I know what you think now, and I say you are absolutely right. Off-grid living, yes. That becomes a reality with this system, because it consumes so little. Off-grid is a good option, but for many of you, excessive. But still, energy supplies can't be reliable as they were until now, if they have not the money to follow the trend of quick electrification. Look towards all those new heat pumps and electric vehicles. That is good in itself, but if the system is not strong enough, you are in the dark.
Oh no!
A step towards independence is to have reserve power system, like the one discussed in the last video about the micro CHP. combined heat and power. I try to guide you towards money saving, protecting the climate and becoming less dependent. This channel is focused on energy, because that is already complicated enough to fill my channel with exciting stuff every week. If you agree with that and you want to improve your energy situation, please like this video, share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel. So let's now see how I will build this system, and I hope that many of you will follow. One component is a second-hand dehumidifier that you have to dismount. I see them on sale for prices below 100 euro. Two ventilation ducts of 10 centimeter diameter, which I will make with this 25 euro drill bit of Amazon. It is compatible with my 90 euro drill motor of 600 watts. And then there are two fans to create airflow in and out. Standard restroom fans remove about 80 cubic meters per hour and they make noise. This can be avoided because with 500 watts from the heat pump, you can anyway heat only 40 cubic meters per hour, increasing it with 30 degrees Celsius. That's much less air. These fans here are overrated and I will run them below their nominal speed so that they will be more silent. The calculated 40 cubic meters per hour are enough for a room of 40 square meters. This is no typo with cubic and square meters. If this room is 3 meter high, you get one air change every 3 hours, and that's enough. It's enough for this big room of 6 by 7 meters. However, the heat of this whole device may be insufficient when it is cold outside, but it gives anyway a significant contribution to the central heating. And when it is not so cold, then it can be enough. And that might reduce your heating season by maybe 1 month per year. And in summer, it works in reverse. It cools the incoming air while removing excess humidity. So this system is for the whole year. Quattro stagioni. So what do we get? A system that keeps the air healthy and fresh, but not cold. Prevents ventilation heat loss in the winter. Improves comfort. Contributes to heating your home, works in the summer too, and it runs on low power, and that's good for off-grid living. It is also do-it-yourself friendly. Would you install a system like this? Let me know in the comments. And if you want to have more do-it-yourself energy-saving projects, hit that subscribe button and put on the notifications. I see you in the next video, and I think that will be about supercapacitors.